As the main unit continue in Panama, a small airport just outside the Mexican town of San Felipe is the base for the aerial unit. Filming is about to commence, shooting a complicated dogfight sequence featuring a low-tech vintage DC-3.
These are propeller-driven planes, not jet planes. It's the type of planes that drug runners would have, and so it fits the location.
Everything you choose, if it's cars or planes or boats, everything has a character.
We needed a place that had the kind of mountains that might match the ones that we'd find in Chile, but because of the equipment we needed, we couldn't take it all down to northern Chile. It would have just been too difficult logistically to get it there.
We went to a place that never rains and the weather's always calm. And I proceeded to lose a third of my shoot time because of weather issues.
I'm running out of weather options at this point, as far as wind is concerned.
Michael, just tell me what's happening.
Too windy, we're going home. Leaving our stuff here to come back in the morning.
When they're flying 10 feet off the ground and there's windshield change the altitude of the plane by 20 feet, that's an obvious problem.
You're having to counteract these forces that's beating you up, plus keep track and do what you're supposed to be doing down the canyon. But it's the wind currents are just bits pounding you from right to left. Sometimes the only thing between the bottom of the airplane and the ground is just the top of the cactus.
This is a Sia Marchetti turbine-powered airplane. It is built by the Italians, and it's built as a military trainer.
You come down under the DC-3 and then pull up at S and come by.
We're flying very close to each other. We're flying in each other's wake, and then we're very low to the ground, a lot of obstacles. And then on top of that, the air is all mixed up because of all the, the weather conditions we've been having.
We have aerial cameras. We have two cameras on an Aerostar, and we have space cams on helicopters. Then we have some very long lenses up to 1600 millimeter that go on the ground to give us a real base and sense of speed and how close these guys are to the ground. For every one camera position up here in the mountains, it takes three helicopter trips in and three helicopter trips out.
Because our locations are so far from the airport, we have remote location, our base camps.
Physically getting to the canyon base camps is a daily challenge for the ground crew. Road access is often, at best, basic.
What about up here? There's no sand up here.
Okay. You're going to have to hang here for
whatever.
A second. He's going to have to come back and get you. Just wait here, let us Baja this out, and then Gabby will come back with a sensible ride for you.
I'll pick up the different people from those locations. We take out about four or five passengers at a time with the helicopter and put them in the remote sites. We sling load the nets full of camera equipment and survival equipment in case for some reason we can't get them off the top of the mountains.
With guns on the back and no registration numbers and country where you have to have a permit to do anything, we've been treated with great suspicion.
Colón is an extraordinary place, never been photographed really before, and has made the film visually very, very exciting.
Colón is the northern end of the Panama Canal, the Caribbean side.
One of the reasons I chose the location is because it has this incredible flavor. It has this architecture and these colors one can't really recreate.
When I saw it, I said, this is a magical place. To me, it's like going to be shooting in the Colosseum. You're in a place that has so much history.
Setting up a shoot of this size in a city unused to filmmaking requires a huge amount of preparation.
The logistics of just filming in this city, it's major stuff that we've done here. We've had to clean streets, we've had to sanitize buildings. We've had to move 500 people. We've had to move out of where they live into alternative accommodation in order that we can shoot there.
James, move your ass.
Sit down! Sit down!
We'll
happy to do that because we were doing a lot of renovation works. Within the building, there were 12 communal bathrooms for 150 families. So we've spent a lot of money trying to replumb the city. It's been an interesting experience, to be honest.
Cologne's proximity to the sea meant that a second unit could work simultaneously to film the boat chase, giving Bond girl Olga Kurylenko her first taste of action.
What the hell are you doing?
You're welcome!
You idiot, take me back!
You know, maybe I'll do that later!
They're doing stunts on a moving boat, and it's not against a green screen. So that's always, you're always a little nervous that the performance is there, but at the same time, you're getting what you want action-wise.
Olga's doing fantastically well. I think she's realizing she's in a Bond movie now because we started doing the boat stunts, and it can be a sore experience.
Get down!
It always starts with me saying, oh, there's no way I can do it. And Daniel he really helped me overcome my fear. He was there, and after each take, he would ask me, are you okay, are you okay? He's very, very caring.
I think people were slightly nervous, if not dubious, about coming and filming in Cologne. I think everybody's experience here has been really good.
We're very privileged to have these experiences and to work with local people and get to know them and get to understand the culture.
People seem to be so excited about us being here. It's been a joy to do it, and I think it's reflected on what we've been shooting.
And the crew had a whip around for helping some of the school children with their school clothes and books and things like that. I think they're all moved to do something for the people that live there.
The important thing is we've got to leave this place a bit better than when we found it, and that's what we plan to do.